Okay, I'm back with the Diabolique Tarot. It's a Los Carabeo deck, and I think it's a limited edition type of publishing. But it is a Los Carabeo deck, and it has to do with comic books, so I just had to have it. The strange thing about this deck is that apparently it's for Italians only, because normally in a Los Carabeo deck, you get a little white book with all kinds of different languages, and this doesn't happen in the Diabolique Tarot. There is a little pamphlet that comes with it, and it's in Italian only. So I started to translate the whole thing, throwing it in Google Translate, and the funny thing is that thanks to this I found out that if I go to Google and I type in Italian English or Italian Dutch, I can type in the words, but I can also press on that little camera thingy, and then it translates the book. It's more accurate when I type in every word or every sentence one at a time, but this way I had no idea that this was an option. This is so cool. So right now I'm sort of making this video using a camera, and in front of the camera is a camera, and that camera is reading and translating the little pamphlet that comes with it. It changes everything. It's fantastic. So here the descriptions are in Italian, but when I put the camera in front of it, it becomes sort of, you know, ta-da! It's so cool. So an Italian only thingy. And it's a weird deck. Apparently it has nothing to do with tarot, or little to do with tarot, and you have to go a little bit crazy and let your imagination do go through a creative process to find the tarot meanings in it. But it's about a superhero and a lots of criminals and villains, and a lot of death, destruction and criminal activity. So this is the Fool. And what I was thinking, it is not, I think, the most beautiful creation, but it is super fun, and I love comic books. But I have a marker or a pen here, and then I was thinking it would be cool to use a marker and write the meanings on the card just for the fun of it, like they did in the old days. So the devil, I can just, you know, I have to find a pen that is able to write words on a shiny glossy. Los Carabeo is going to kill me, but I always wanted to write on my cards, and maybe this is the deck that is going to be ruined by me writing on it. If you know what type of marker I can use to make this happen, that would be fantastic, because right now I don't know if I can use a permanent marker or an ordinary pen, or I don't know yet. But I think it's kind of tempting, you know, to do it. I really always wanted a deck that I could write my interpretations on, and this might be a very good deck to use. So this is the Hermit, L'Eremita. My Italian is non-existent, La Forza. There's a lot of violence in it, and it's dark, and it's cruel, and it's fierce, and it's dangerous, and And I'm looking for decks that give me good readings. I'm not looking for the most beautiful deck anymore. So I love comic books. I used to have loads, boxes filled with comic books, but this was a comic book character that I am not familiar with, and I couldn't find any reviews on it, and that made me want to check it out. And it's simple, it's effective, it's, I don't know, it's written off a lot of unnecessary details, and that's something that I started to enjoy a bit more. I am very happy with this purchase. I don't know, it's arty. It's simple, yet it works very well. And there were some books about Diabolique on the Los Caraveo website, but they were awfully expensive, so I am not sure about whether or not I should buy these. But look at this, it's fantastic. Look at this, it's so simple. The way the gun is done is beautiful. Very strong Queen of Wands. Comic books are so fascinating and so, it's an art style. It is art. Isn't this the best Nine of Swords you've ever seen? And it's blue, it's red, it's yellow, it's black, it's totally not my style, and yet it is for some odd reason. So going through the deck one more time. Comic books are so cool. I so love cards like this. It's the same with the Primordial Tarot. There is not a lot of detail, but everything that is in the card should be there and shows it all. It's enough, and that makes the cards and the art strong. But no information in English, so I'm going to use my magic camera. I have to say that if I use the translator, the typing in every word individually, making sentences, that's more accurate than using the camera. So all these basic colors, look at this. And the backs aren't delightful either. And yet, I don't know, it's something about this that, and I don't regret buying this at all. It's not going to be a deck that I will rehome sooner or later. But like I said, I want to know if I can write on these cards and how I should do it. But if you know, please help me out. So that was the Diabolique tarot. Comes in a beautiful sturdy box. This was 1674 out of 1962. That had a special meaning, but I forgot about it. So that's it. See you next time. Bye.